Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to drag, rotate, and snap the rotation of an isometric camera. This could look something like this. I will keep the introduction brief, but if you're new to Unity's new input system, have a look at the first video I recorded for my Simple Character Controller series, link in the description. If you're not using Unity's new input system, click on Window, choose Package Manager, and install the input system. Let Unity restart, and once you're back, right-click in the Assets folder and create a new folder called Input. Inside of the Input folder, right-click and create a new Input Actions object. Call it Input Actions and open up your new Input Actions. Create an action map called Gameplay. And you can just remove the action here and create a new one. Call it Look, set the action type to Pass Through and the control type to Vector2. For the binding, choose Mouse and Delta. Remember to save your inputs here with the Save Asset button. Now, if you don't already have one, create a Scripts folder and add a new script called Camera Manager. Drag it onto your main camera object and make sure to set the projection to orthographic instead of perspective. Set the size to whatever is good for your game. I will go with a value of 20 and set the near clipping planes to a negative value. You can also reset the transform up here and set the rotation to 30 on the x-axis, 45 on the y-axis and 0 on the z-axis. Open up the Camera Manager script and start by including UnityEngine.InputSystem in the top here. Now, create a public method called onLook and pass in InputAction.CallbackContext and for simplicity, call it Context. Now, let's create a private variable of type Vector2 called Delta. Down in our new method, type delta equals context.readValue, vector2 within angle brackets, and finish up with opening and closing parentheses and a semicolon. This will get us the vector2 value from the mouse. And let's type debug.logDelta, just to make sure everything is working in Unity. In the hierarchy, let's now create an empty game object called playerInput and add a new playerInput component onto that. For the actions, either drag your player input actions into the slot here or choose the object by clicking on the tiny dot to the right here. For the behavior, choose Invoke Unity Events. Under Events and Gameplay, you can now find your look event. Click on the plus symbol down here. Drag your main camera to the object field, and as for its function, choose Camera Manager and on look. Hit play and look at your console. You should now be getting outputs of Vector2 values. For moving the camera, we can just create a new action called Move, leave the type as Button. For its binding, let's set it to Mouse and Left Button. Let's also create another one called Rotate. Same here, type Button, but set the binding to Mouse and Right Button. Save the asset and let's write code for this. Let's first remove the debug.log here, since we know it's working now. To keep this simple, I'll just create some new variables here. First, a private boolean named isMoving. Let's also create a private boolean named isRotating. Create a new public method called onMove, and as we did up here, we need a callback context, so copy and paste it for the onMove method. Below that, create a new public method called onRotate and get the callback context here as well. Let's first take care of the movement. I talked about this in a previous video, but context gives us three states, started, performed, and cancelled. And lucky for us, these are booleans. Started is fired as soon as you click the mouse button, performed as long as you're holding down the button, and cancelled as soon as you lift up your finger. For this, we can set this moving to context.started or context.performed. As soon as we start, and as long as we're performing this action, as in holding down our mouse button, the isMoving boolean is set to true, and otherwise it will be false. Do the same for onRotate, but set the isRotating boolean instead. Open up Unity again, choose the player input object, and let's add move and rotate under events and gameplay the same way we did before. Click the plus symbol, drag your camera to the object field, and choose the corresponding function. Repeat for both move and rotate. To test this out, we can choose our camera in the hierarchy, click the three dots in the top right corner and choose debug. Scroll down until you find your camera manager script and have a look at the is moving and the is rotating booleans. If I hit play now and click anywhere in the game scene, the is moving boolean will stay true for as long as I keep holding the button down. Same with the is rotating boolean, if I press down my right mouse button, it will be true, and when I let go, it will go back to false. Everything seems to be working, so let's go back to our script. Now, add a late update method where we will be doing the camera updates. Let's first check if is moving. Now, we are going to need a new variable here, so in the top, create a new serialized float called movement speed. I will set the default value to 10. Because we're using an isometric camera, the movement may look a bit different to what you are used to, but just follow along. In the late update method, within the if statement, we can now type var position equals transform.right multiplied by and within parentheses delta.x multiplied by a negative movement speed. Now type position plus equals transform.up multiplied by and within parentheses delta.y multiplied by a negative movement speed. And finally transform.position plus equals position multiplied by time.deltaTime. Let's jump back into Unity to try this out. Make sure the movement speed has a value above 0 in the inspector, click anywhere in the game scene and drag your mouse. Your camera should now be moving and we can jump back into our code to take care of the rotation. Let's first create a private float up here called xRotation and in an awake function set it to transform.rotation.eulerangles.x. The xRotation value should be 30, but in case you ever want to change the xRotation of the camera, we don't have to worry about a hard-coded value this way. Let's also create a serialized float called rotation speed. I will set the default value to 0.5. Down in the late update method, we can check if is rotating and type transform.rotate a new vector 3 with the xRotation variable on the x-axis and negative delta x multiplied by the rotation speed on the y-axis and 0 on the z-axis. Let's also type transform.rotation equals quaternion.euler with the xRotation variable on the x-axis, transform.rotation.eulerangles.y on the y-axis and 0 on the z-axis. With this you should be all good to go, so let's try this out in Unity. Make sure the rotation speed is set to a value above 0 and hit play. Now you can drag your camera with the left mouse button and rotate with the right one. You can now rotate as much as you want, but we can further expand upon this by making the camera snap to certain values. While you're still in Unity, make sure you have DoTween installed. It's a free plugin on the asset store that makes tweening super simple, and you will find a link to the asset store down in the description. Import the package from Package Manager, let it install, open the utility panel, and set it up to work with Unity by clicking on the Setup DoTween button here. Wait for a while, hit apply, and let's write some code for this. First, we are going to scroll down and create a new method that returns a vector3 called snapped_vector. Let's type var endValue equals 0, followed by var currentY equals mathf.seal and within parentheses transform.rotation.eulerangles.y. This, according to the documentation, returns the smallest integer greater to or equal to f. Now, this could probably be shortened, but I prefer the clarity of this. Type endValue equals currentY switch and within curly braces greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 90 and an arrow function returning 45. Repeat this with 91 and 180 returning 135, 181 and 270 returning 225, and finally an underscore returning 315. Don't worry if it's confusing, we are simply setting the end value depending on the current y value with a switch statement. So if, when we let go of the right mouse button, the camera's current y-axis is between 0 and 90, this will return an end value of 45 degrees. If it's between 91 and 180, the end value is 135, and the default, which essentially is between 271 and 360, returns 315. Now, below this, let's type return new vector3 with the xRotation variable on the x-axis, end value on the y-axis, and 0 on the z-axis. Now, let's scroll back up again, and in the top here we are going to type using dg.tweening. We can also create a new private boolean called isBusy. Now, in the onRotate method, let's check if isBusy, then return. Now, let's check if contextCancelled, meaning this is where we lift our finger, then set isBusy to true. Let's now create a new private method called snapRotation. Call it right after you set isBusy to true. In your snapRotation method, type transform.doRotate. And as its first parameter, type snappedVector and set the duration to 0.5. Now, let's set the easing by typing .setEase and within parentheses, type ease.outBounce. And finally, .onComplete, opening and closing parentheses. And this is an arrow function, so curly braces here. This is called as soon as the rotation is done. In here, we can now set the isBusy boolean back to false. Let's jump back into Unity to try everything out. First, we can move our camera by clicking anywhere and dragging. We can rotate our camera by right-clicking. And when we let go of the right mouse button, the camera will rotate and snap to the closest predefined rotation, with some easing making it bounce a bit. And that is it for this tutorial. If you have any questions or feedback, let me know and I'll try my best to help you. You will find a link to this code on GitHub down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.